Welcome to tonight's J-Rack production of Most of a Nickel, Jeremy Kahn's 2005 album, a retelling of the Threepenny Opera by Kurt Weill. With us tonight is also Alex Puryear at the brushes, and you know the score now. This is the virtual tip jar. Donate. It's really nice. Without further ado, we have on drums, Eric Montzka. On bass, Larry Kohut. On sax and alto flute, Jim Gailloreto. And Jeremy Kahn on piano. Let's go.
There in streamy land. Welcome. As you heard, we are recreating a recording that we made 15 years ago and somehow never got around to performing until about 6 months ago, which I guess we could call maybe our dress rehearsal. So we're happy to have another shot at it here. Threepenny Opera, Kurt Weill, written in 1930 or so. So the pieces that you're hearing aren't exactly the way they were in 1930, but they're pretty close in terms of the melody and the chords. We changed the grooves a little bit. This groove stays the same. It's called Tango. It's a tender love song between a pimp and one of his employees. So. So picture that, if you will. So here's Tango. Two. One, two. Thank you. That's tango. Spelled backwards is Agnat. Just if you want to think about it. Here's a tune called Pirate Jenny. And we call this kind of our tag team song because it really is just a series of duets with a slight bit of overlap. So if you're keeping score at home, the duets go something like this. Sax bass, sax drums, piano bass, piano sax. Does that sound right? Okay, just checking. So I don't have to play at the beginning. That's good. And send some texts to Eric. One, two, three, four. That's Pirate Jenny. She was some kind of gal. So a little bit about the Threepenny Opera. Based on something called the Beggar's Opera, written in the 1800s, I think. Could be, you could look it up. But has all sorts of themes of, you know, a struggle between the haves and the have-nots, and corrupt politicians, and overly brutal law enforcement techniques. So thank God we've evolved past all that and live in a much happier time where we all love each other. As a segue, here's a song called Love Song, which in German is called Liebeslied. So that's what we're gonna play for you right now. Hope you do enjoy. Thank you. Thank you. Got a couple more here for this set. So I should have said our first set is all stuff from our Threepenny Opera recording. Then we're going to take a short break and think about what we've done, and we'll be back and play more Kurt Weill stuff, but this is from his more American kind of Broadway period. So did I just?
You did.
I did that. They can fix that with Pro Tools, right? Okay, so here's the famous song recorded by Bobby Darin and Louis Armstrong and Ella Fitzgerald. On the record, what you hear are three kind of weird versions of Mack the Knife, one just by myself, one by Jim Gailloreto, one by Larry Kohut. We didn't let Eric have one. That would have been scary. But for performance sake, we've kind of mushed them all together and come into what I like to think of as sort of the vamp from hell. And if you're keeping score again, this in 11/8 time, hopefully, which is a lot like just marching regular if one of your legs is a lot shorter than the other one. But what could possibly go wrong? Here is Mack the Knife. Thank you. Thank you. That's Mack the Knife with the runcipal spoon was implied in that. We've got all sorts of flatware floating around. The idea was that Jim just played it in regular 4/4 time while the rest of us played it in 11. But Jim's the one that ends up looking like the weirdo. So we hope that it worked. No. You're so normal to us. Did we do? Oh. Yeah, the next one is called what?
Solomon.
Yeah. Thought my pages were out of order, but I'm generally out of order. This is a beautiful song called Solomon's Song. We start with, we're going to have Jim on the alto flute. And starts with Larry Kohut doing a thing. Go ahead. Thank you. Thank you. If we could get some security in here, there's some rowdiness going on with the crowd. Thank you. This next song is called Cannon Song, sung by a bunch of drunken policemen, as I recall. And the only lyric that I remember, because I played this show in 1980 or something like that, the only word that I remember from the song is beefsteak tartare. So think of raw beef while you hear us play this. It's called Cannon Song, and it starts with Eric Montzka with his whacked out military groove. Wherever you like it. Thank you. That's Eric Montzka on the beefsteak tartare drums over there. We're down to our penultimate song of this set, whatever that means. This is a lovely tune called Barbara Song. Interesting, there's no character named Barbara in the show Threepenny Opera, but it's kind of weird like that. Good old Bertolt Brecht. So here we go, Barbara song. Larry's got the bow, so everybody look out. He's been practicing. Thank you. you. Hey, 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 calm down, everybody. Our last set, our last piece for this set is called No, They Can't. But first, I want to thank some very special people. They know who they are. Casey on sound, Jose, our host. Alex, doing a lovely job. Harvey on photos, and they definitely can. But here's a song called No, They Can't. So it has nothing to do with them. Starts with Larry Kohut. Brace yourself. Thank you. Thank you, Jim, Eric, Larry, our music, Jeremy. We'll be back soon. Thank you so much. Thank you for that rousing ovation. Here we go. That's my ship. That's my ship. Written in 1941. You know, most of Ira Gershwin's career, of course, was spent writing songs with his brother George. But that slowed down a little bit when George died, of course. So, I don't think that's funny at all. So, Ira did write songs with some other folks, including Kurt Weill. After Kurt moved to the United States to get away from Germany, where some unfortunate things were going on. So in 1941, Ira wrote that with Kurt Weill from a show called Lady in the Dark. We are continuing with, what are we doing? Are we doing Speak Low? I had it written wrong on my piece of paper, but thank you for listening. Thank you for sitting on your couch. Hello, everybody out in Streamland, Streamwood, Carol Stream. Anybody got any other ones? Carol Scream. All right, so here's a song called Speak Low, written by Kurt Weill, and the lyricist this time. You won't hear the words, but just pretend. Ogden Nash, who mainly wrote silly poems, but the lyrics are pretty good, trust me. So here we are. Speak Low. And I hope that my music doesn't blow all over the place. I'm going to be clever and reposition it. Talk amongst yourselves for 1 minute. Okay, we're good. One, two, three, four. Thank you. you. Speak low. Darling, speak low. Now we're going to do a song written by Kurt Weill, obviously, and Langston Hughes wrote the lyrics. That again, you will not hear. 1947 from a show called Street Scene. It's an atmospheric little ditty called Lonely House. Thank you. Thank you. That was Lonely House. What's next? Oh, another Ira Gershwin lyric that you won't hear. We have stolen. What's a good euphemism for that? We liberated this arrangement from a Chick Corea version. Yeah, don't tell him. But of course, you know, it's not his song, so we're allowed. This is a very cool tune called This Is New from a show called Lady in the Dark. Sounds scary. No bass on this. And it goes a little something like this. Sorry. My showbiz roots showing. Thank you. Thank you. I can tell you that as a quartet, we're glad to get that ending out of the way. It's fraught. Here's a lovely song that doesn't involve Eric and Larry. They could either sit there and look pretty, or they can go play tic-tac-toe in the corner. So it's a beautiful song. Who wrote the lyrics to this? Maxwell Anderson. And it's called Lost in the Stars. It's going to feature an attempt at a party trick. It has to do with vibrating piano strings. And I need to find my roadmap. Here it is. Okay. I got it. With many cadenzas. It's all about setting things up. Here we go. Thank you. Thank you. Lost in the Stars, Jim Gailloreto over there. With his gaggle of instruments, tenor, soprano, and the flutey thing, alto. All you have to do is just ask it, I'll stop talking. You have to mace me. That's Larry Kohut over there on the bass. Eric Montzka on the drums over there. We're going to do one more song for you. This was introduced by a guy who really couldn't sing, but he had a wonderful presence. Walter Houston, John Houston's dad, who directed movies. But what's this from? It's from something. It's from a show, I bet. Yeah, it's from a show called Knickerbocker Holiday. But of course, you knew that. So, the K word. So, we are going to conclude with September Song. It's been our profound pleasure to be here. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Thanks to everybody in the room here who helped us bring this to life. And we look forward to seeing everybody in 3D at some point in the not too distant future. Who knows? Maybe in September of 2029. Thank you so much. We'll see you around. Jim, Eric, Larry, Jeremy, and you all. Bye-bye.